Peggy 3.
A very happy new year to you all. You're watching The Boot Room and we're back with more tips for FIFA 13. Specifically this week, we're looking at teams to use in Seasons mode. Isn't that right, Darren?
Yeah, that's right. We've got a bunch of teams to look at that are great in Seasons and they could really help you move through the divisions.
Now, we're looking at four teams today. We're broadening our horizons because none of these are Premiership teams and they're also all four stars or below. Why is that?
Yeah, I think four-star level and below is fantastic to use online because it's that little bit more forgiving. So the games tend to be nice and open and you don't always get punished when somebody goes through on goal, perhaps as you would do at 4.5 star or 5 star level.
Now the first team we're going to look at is a Belgian team, it's Anderlecht, and they're 3.5 stars, aren't they?
Yeah, and they're really my favourite team to use online in FIFA 13 at the moment, and that's because they've got great players in key areas. So the centre-backs are very good, the strikers are very good, there's some really creative midfielders in there as well. What I particularly like about Anderlecht is the pace and the power that they've got, both at the back and in attack, which at this level can be really devastating.
So does that mean if you're playing online and someone is through on goal, you've got a better chance to recover?
Exactly, and that's one of the plus points of having strong, quick defenders at the back. When someone does go through on goal, there's a really good chance you're going to recover, whereas at 4.5 star or 5 star level, you'll probably be punished.
Now let's move next door. Let's move next door to France. We're going to look at Marseille. Why are they so good?
Yeah, Marseille are a 4-star club and they're really well balanced. They've kind of got strength, pace, skill all over the pitch really. Starting in goal, the goalkeeper's fantastic. The back four, if you tinker with it a bit, can be set up to be really quick. You've got technical ability through the midfield and then a couple of real match winners in there, particularly in attacking midfield and up front. Again, up front, lots of pace and some really good finishing ability, so goals galore.
What's the best play style that suits that team?
Well, that's what I really like about Marseille. Depending on which players you choose in the starting lineup, you can really tweak them to fit your style of play. So if you like fast wingers, they've got that. If you prefer creativity out there, they've got that. You know, if you want a strong striker that can finish, yep. You know, but if you just want to go for pace, they've got that as well. So they are really well balanced and that's why I like using them online.
So on our virtual tour of Europe, let's head south. Let's go to an Italian club, Udinese.
Yeah, Udinese are fantastic to use. They're a 4-star club. And the reason why I like using them so much is the strike force. It's fantastic at this level. You know, you're going to score a lot of goals with Udinese.
So they're fantastic up front, but there is a downside, isn't there?
Yeah, and that's the defence, in all honesty. It's probably not, well, it's nowhere near as good as the strike force. So that's the real payoff here. If you're great going forward, you're going to really enjoy using Udinese. But if you're not so hot on defending, you're probably going to get caught a few times when the opponent team has the ball because there's not a great deal of pace at the back with Udinese, so you are susceptible to counter-attacks.
So if you want a high-scoring game and you might want to please the virtual crowd, you want to go for Udinese?
Yeah, games I play with them often end 4-3 to me or 3-4, but it's always a good fun game to play, and that's another reason why I really like using them. You always feel like you're going to score every time you go forward.
Now let's move on to the last club. This is one you may not have heard of. It's Anzhi, and they're in a strange place that I can't pronounce.
Yeah, Anzhi Makhachkala.
Bless you.
Thank you. From the Russian Premier Division. They're a 4-star side. I've used them a lot. I used them a lot in FIFA 12. They were really successful there, but they're even better in 13, I think, thanks to the addition of a 6-foot-8-inch striker.
He's a giant.
He is, yeah. And with his strike partner up there, it's you know that you can score a lot of goals with Anzhi. But where they differ from Udinese, and they're not just about the strike partnership, they've got strength in midfield, and if you move the defence about a bit, you can put pace and power at the back. So again, a good all-round team, but with real match winners up front.
Some really great teams there, but let's briefly talk formations. There's one you like to stick to, isn't there?
Yeah, that's right. It's the 4-4-2 diamond wide, which was previously called the 4-1-2-1-2.
Easier to say 4-4-2 diamond wide, I think.
Yeah, it is. And it's really easy to use as well, and that's why I like it. You know, I'm really familiar with the positions of the players, so I always know where people are going to be at certain times, and that's great if you're using a team that you've never played as before because you've got, you know, the security of knowing where the players will be. So I use that formation with all four of these teams. Occasionally I'll switch to a different shape if I think they've got the players to benefit, but I always start with that shape to begin with.
And are you using any of these teams at the moment?
Yeah, it's Anderlecht. You know, I can't stop playing as them at the minute just because they've got that fantastic defence and great strike force. So they're really good fun to use.
Well, Darren, I might try playing as Anderlecht because at the moment I usually play as Liverpool and, like real life, I usually lose, which is a shame. Darren, what are we looking at next week?
Next week we're going to look at defending and the different ways to defend against different types of players.
Excellent, I look forward to it. You can catch Darren Cross in Match Magazine every Tuesday and we'll see you next week. Bye.